Libra, let's jump into love and see what comes up for you Librans in the cards. Okay, this is powerful, Libra. You've got the King and the Queen of Cups. Now, it's not very often we see the King and Queen of their element pop up together, and the fact that they've come up, this shows a lot. Okay, this is a very emotional connection that's forming. Okay, it might be coming from a water sign, because you've got the cups here, so you've got four out of the five cards, which was water elements, and you did have water cards in the general reading as well. But look, I feel like the King and the Queen of Cups represent a lot of compassion and tenderness, but also a lot of love for each other. Now, I don't know if there's an exodus happening, but for some of you, there might be someone leaving your life, or you might be leaving theirs, Libra. And what I want to say is that you'll still care about each other. It's, you know, it's a tough situation to be in. I think for a lot of you, there could be some sort of separation that you might experience, at least on some level in your relationships, whether it's separation anxiety, being apart from your mate, whether it's separating because you decide to go different ways, whether it's a minor separation, a very brief separation, or whether it's ending the relationship. There is something here that's definitely going to impact you. And look, it could be your decision. It might be the decision you decide for the relationship or for each other. I feel like with the King of Swords, it might be your idea, or you might bring up certain topics, or you might bring up the fact that you are wanting to move on. I feel it's more to do something that you will instigate this walking away. You'll either push this person away consciously or subconsciously, you'll end up walking away from them, or you pushing them away will end up them leaving, but there's still care. You'll be scratching your head as to what's happened here. This is emotional overwhelming here happening with the Seven of Cups. So emotions could be really scattered or up and down, but I feel at the end of the day, you still care a lot about each other. And this could even be regarding an ex. And I say that because the Moon can represent the sign of Cancer. Cancer signs and Cancer energy holds on to the past, often still having residual feelings from a past attachment, relationship, and or connection. So the fact that that's coming up might just indicate that it could be someone from the past. Whether you reunite is hard to say, but there's definitely a lot of love here. Okay, there's definitely still a lot of care and a lot of love. You might be talking to this person. They may come back around in your life. And you may have those declarations of, I still love you. But something has happened between the two of you. And it's either things are at a standstill and you might not see much progress, or things repeat itself and there's still some unresolved conflict. There's still some dwelling that's happening here on something that has happened or will happen. Dwelling from you, dwelling from them, perhaps from the both of you. And this might impact your ability to move on either with each other or move on completely. Now, for some of you, it's not that situation at all. For some of you, this is equally the both of you falling in love, falling back in love with someone, falling in love with someone for the first time, having a deep attachment or care about them, or noticing how much you care or love them or want them in your life. So for a lot of you, this is going to happen. Absolutely. The King of Swords shows a very strong mental connection as much as it's a very strong emotional connection between the two of you. Your mental connection with each other will be quite strong as well. You'll want to talk about things. The King of Swords wants to air it out. There's something that you'll have to air out. Going the distance. I don't know if this is like a long distance connection or talking about like foreign love. But if you do have something like that, you might be reunited with this person. They might come to you. They might journey to you. You might journey to them. But there's a notion of being separated by space or time that will plague you potentially this month, or will plague the other person, or even the both of you for that matter. Because the Seven is things are overwhelming. I don't know where I stand. I need that clarification. And then eight is on the search for that clarification. Eight is the seven that follows. Eight follows the seven, and there's the searching out, there's the going out. I mean, it can be someone turning their back on a situation, okay? Some of you might be reaching out to someone, hoping to talk and air things out and have some sort of resolution. And whilst there are still emotions for you, they might turn your back on what it is that you're aiming to do. Maybe not forever, maybe for now, maybe you need to wait for them to come around to Libra, or vice versa, they need to wait for you to come around. That could be the case as well. But very much an emotional month, okay? Something could be missing in the relationship. You might be, you know, losing your identity. You might be wanting to find yourself. There's maybe soul searching that needs to happen, or a separation. I don't know. Every situation is going to be different, but that's just food for thought, I suppose. And you want that clear head. You know, you've got the King of Swords here, so you need that validation. And look, the situation can be different for all. And if you are dealing with an air sign, it could be that this person wants to rush things with you. It could be that they're very determined to have you by their side. Okay, they're very eager or anxious to have you by their side. Let's have a look and see what's coming up in terms of career. Creative pursuits, finances. Okay, new opportunities on the horizon here. Very nice, Libra. You've got a beautiful Ace of Swords. New opportunities for the air sign, which is you. Now, this is very powerful. It does symbolize divine intervention at its best here. So it might be an opportunity you need to fight for, though, okay? The Ace of Swords doesn't come easy. It does require a struggle or copious amounts of time, energy, effort being diverted into something. So if you have had some sort of lengthy application process to jobs or academies or schools or industries, that opportunity might just pay off here. And then the Wheel of Fortune, you complete the cycle, and it's all about divine timing for an opportunity that you've been striving for quite some time. So for those that have had obstacles, delays, you felt shut out, you felt like you weren't being responded to, you weren't being updated, that could come, and there could be a lot of information and or correspondence coming to you. The Wheel of Fortune can also symbolize more money, and it's very interesting that you're going from the Five of Pentacles to the Seven to the Nine to the Knight. So I definitely feel like your money situation could turn around completely. It could do a complete 180, come around full circle, or something about cycles of money. So patterns or cycles. You might go from being very wealthy to in a situation where you need money, or vice versa, a situation where you're very tight on money, and then going into having those extra funds. So be careful not to overindulge, though, okay? So make sure cycles don't repeat itself. But for the most part, Wheel of Fortune indicates an improvement in career or money, working hours, and things of that nature. Some of you are learning something new with the Six of Cups. The children could symbolize learning and development or progress, okay? So there's you're making some sort of progress. And albeit baby steps and very, very slowly, there's still some sort of progress that you're making, believe it or not, okay? But the Six of Cups can also indicate a meeting, okay? Meeting someone, being introduced to someone, in a professional sphere, in the creative sphere. It could also be childhood dreams. It could be working from home or starting to work from home. Six of Cups could also be someone from the past coming back in. Maybe a past employer reaching out. Maybe someone you used to work with. Maybe they have an idea they'd like to share with you. Maybe they just want to reconnect on friendly terms. But I feel like there's some sort of involvement here, but in a good way, Libra, in a way where you can accelerate in terms of growth and career, which is really nice. The Seven and the Nine of Pentacles, I do see more money for some of you. Possibly analyzing something or looking how far you've come in a situation, collecting resources, mapping things out, okay, getting a bird's eye view of how you can do things differently, the approaches you've done, what's worked, what hasn't. But I think for the most part, there is more money coming in. Got the Nine of Pentacles. This is a card of being very comfortable with money and resources and surroundings. It could also be a luxurious person or affluent person or luxurious or affluent venue that's coming in around you, sprucing up the home office, changes to the workplace, opening up a second franchise. Again, aces are new chapters. They don't come easy. But I feel like even if you are trying to strive for something or achieve it, possess it or pitch it, get it out there, it's not going to come easy, but it's going to pay off. The rewards and the dividends are there for you, Libra. You have to trust the process. You have to know that whatever it is that's holding you back, that's delaying you, that's proving difficult, will ultimately pay off in the end. And you'd be wise to remember that, okay? Sometimes as an air sign, your anxiousness can get the better of you. And I can relate as a Gemini, absolutely. But I think that's something to remember that's key. That's a key point, actually. But I do hope it's been helpful. It's given you food for thought. Something to think about and also giving you some insight. We'll catch up soon. Thanks again, Libra. Bye for now.